we've got two swarms that jumped out of that box, those Langstroth hives right there. So after that cavity gets filled up, the queen goes on a mating flight, and she takes off about a mile high, and she mates with the fastest, biggest drone, male bee, to relocate. So she's, the queen is in there somewhere, and there she's sending scouts out to find a new home because their old home is maxed out.
And there's a queen in there.
And she lays about 10 or 5, a handful of queen cells. Mm-hmm. Queens are going to wake up in there any minute, and they're going to battle it out until the strongest queen takes over that hive. Now she's sending scouts out to look for a new home. It could be the soffit of your house, it could be the chimney of your house, and most people don't really want bees, so they'll just probably spray them or have somebody kill them.
We got a couple of boxes in that building.
I noticed that. So we're gonna first catch them in a swarm box, which is just a little lid box.
Uh-huh.
And they can stay in here up to like 4 to 6 hours before we relocate them.
Nice.
So as long as I catch the queen, and I cap her in here,
mm-hmm.
all the other bees are gonna come out here and they're gonna start kicking out her pheromone. And then before you know it, you'll see all the bees come in this box because she's in here.
No.
Pretty magic.
Now, what's gonna keep you from getting stung right now?
Right now, they have no
desire, they're docile.
They're so docile. It's like, there's no honey. They have one thing in mind, and that's relocation. So what I'm going to do is, sometimes you cut the branch, I'm just going to put the box underneath, I'm going to give it one hard shake, and 30% is going to hit the box, and I'm going to close it up. Chances are good that she's going to be in the box. So don't run, don't be afraid.
Oh, nice, Jake, guys, well done. Unbelievable, they're not stinging you.
So I'm looking for her up here to see if she's here. Oh, I see her. Oh, I see her. She's not in the box. Here she goes.
She's in the box.
She's in the box now.
Was she much larger than the other ones?
Much. She's a Cadillac compared to the Volkswagen. Uh-huh. Bug. So we're going to leave that about right there. We're going to see if they start going. See that door, that
yep.
window? We're going to see if they go in there.
Yeah. There's one more. We've got another one to catch up in this tree up here.
And most likely that's where these queens came from too. They've booted out of there or whatever their hierarchy is.
Ready? 1, 2. Oh! Ooh, I'm getting nailed. Oh, I'm getting nailed. Mm. They didn't like that.
Well, you're sitting right down on your arm. Getting some things.
I'm here to help.
Hey, kids, boys.
Hold on.
Stop.
Stay
stop.
Back.
Stop. Go back.
You're agitated.
Go back. The bees. Go back. Turn around and go back, dude.
That hurt.
Damn it. That's going to give me a headache.
Do you use like one bite, a bunch of two?
Yeah. Usually it doesn't happen to him.
I think you got her. I think she's in the box.
Yeah?
Well, the bees are...
I still hope so much.
Well, you know, you never know what you're going to get. And that time I felt like it was a little rough. Normally you never get stung in a swarm because they have no interest. They're super docile. But I think I was just moving a little too fast up there. My adrenaline's rocking. And we'll see what happens. that one's getting small.
And they settle down after a while, like once you drop the...
Yeah, after about 20 minutes to a half hour, most of them should go in that box.
Because they all go where the queen was?
Where the queen is. And if you look at the flap, like that one, they're all gathered around the flap. They're kicking out for pheromone so that they can scent it and get it back, go back in the box. That one, I don't see as many hanging out doing that on the doorstep.
Do you use the smoke stuff sometimes?
I don't. I usually just try to smoke a big doobie beforehand and then do it.
Smoke to
hopefully you gotta hold your breath and just blow out on the swarm.
That's like old conventional, you know, to smoke the bees. It's supposed to settle them down. But they think their house is on fire if you smoke the bees. The last thing I want to do is just, I just try to let go of some of those old school mentality and try to work a little bit on the organic side, I guess.
Cool. So I guess, you know, when you get stung, you just gotta be real calm about it.
Yeah.
You start...
Yeah, as soon as you hype up, they hype up. They can really feel you.
Other than you getting stung a lot, you lucked out. It's a perfect day for this gig.
Oh, this is awesome.
It's moseying in the water. Would you try to... Do you got the lid on, or would you try to...
I would do a reshake on that one. If they, if that mass of bees gets bigger. After a good half hour or so, we should know where they want to go.